Today on Commander Replay, it's four times the Boros with two Aurelias, Gisela, and Calamity. Find out who has truly mastered red and white Commander combat next on Commander Replay.
I want to thank my awesome Patreon supporters. We have two new Patreon supporters in Alex S. Barnett and Tom Duje. You guys are awesome. If you want to help support the channel and vote on which decks I play next, feel free to check out my Patreon at the link below. Welcome back, everyone. We got something special today. We got four times the Boros. That is two Aurelias, a Gisela, and a Calamity. Take a look at our opening hand. We've got two lands, Sol Ring, Land Tax, Urza's Incubator, and two board wipes. I think it's keepable. We'll try it. So today I am joined by three Patreon supporters. First up, we have Chaotix2075 piloting Gisela, Blade of Gold Knight. Really powerful commander. And this will be interesting because if Gisela's in play, that means that if we have Aurelia in, we can attack twice into our other opponents and they'll be taking massive amounts of damage. But the same is also true for us. So if we don't have creatures in play that can block, Aurelia and Calamity will be looking to come into us for huge amounts of damage, so something we'll need to be careful of. Gisela's going to start off with a turn one Soul's Attendant. Interesting. Potentially some sort of life gain theme going on. We'll see what's happening there. Next up, we have Aurelia the Warleader being piloted by Zsauce. I have not seen their particular build of Aurelia, but a Patreon supporter of mine and fan of the channel, so I assume that their Aurelia deck is very well informed. We'll see what particular build they decided to focus on for this game. And they start off with the turn one Mana Crypt. Pretty good. Next up, we have Firemaker 282 playing Calamity, Disciple of Irois. Probably one of my least favorite Boros commanders, especially now that they've printed a bunch more over the past few years. In my opinion, there are some better options in the Voltron world now because, I mean, for me, it's just so frustrating that you don't really get to take full advantage of all of Calamity's abilities. Now, if you're comfortable with just the Double Strike and Vigilance aspect of Calamity, yeah, it's very solid. But yeah, you guys have heard me talk about it a little bit over the years. I just don't like how Calamity's second paragraph of text doesn't synergize with its third paragraph of text. Just makes for awkward abilities. But that doesn't necessarily mean that it's a weak commander. If that thing gets suited up Voltron style, it can still come in for huge amounts of damage. So we'll need to be careful of that. And we are playing Aurelia the Warleader, and this is the Angel version, one that I've been playing a lot lately. Just really loving this build. Now that Smothering Tithe has been printed, this deck has just been a blast to play. I've also got it tuned up really, really well. It's running like a dream, so it's just been so much fun for me to play. Do have some other Aurelia decks that I've wanted to build that I've just kind of put on the shelf while I've been playing this one a lot. I do want to do an update on the Weapons of War list, especially now that Smothering Tithe is out. Still trying to get the balance of everything right in that build in the little bit of time that I've had to work on it. Talking some trash with our opponents, saying that Firemaker brought a knife to a gunfight, since they don't have flying. It's called removal, just gonna clip your wings. Yep. And Chaotix saying, Sunday night is Boros ladies' night. It is Sunday night, by the way, when I'm filming this. So, turn one, Blind Obedience coming down for the Aurelia opponent. And my trash talk has stirred up some trash talk amongst our opponents. having some fun with the Patreon supporters. And that's going to bring it to our turn one. We draw into an Aura of Silence. Sweet card. Play the Plains. Play the Sol Ring. Nothing to do with the Sol Ring, so we will pass the turn. It does come in tapped off of the Blind Obedience, so that's good to keep in mind. Temple of Triumph for the Gisela opponent. They get to scry. Mana Crypt Flip for the Aurelia opponent. And they're going to play a Solemn Simulacrum. Very nice. Turn two Solemn off after a Mana Crypt. Yeah, that's pretty good. I am thinking that we probably need to go Aura of Silence next turn and try to slow down any equipments and mana rocks from our opponent, even though Aurelia is already off to a pretty good start. Ooh, I didn't notice this. So the Calamity opponent suspended an Ivory Giant last turn, so five more turns and that'll be in play. So most likely playing Giant Tribal with Calamity, and they're going to lay down a Thought Vessel and pass the turn to us. Ooh, we draw a Reforged Soul. We don't have any red mana. Bummer. So it looks like we are not going to cast that for its miracle cost. So play the Plains. We need to get Land Tax down. All right, so I guess it's going to be Land Tax first. Get Land Tax in, get Urza's Incubator in. Interesting. Ooh, I just remember that Urza's Incubator does work for everyone, which does help two of our opponents. Possibly the third, if there's any angels in the Calamity deck. So we might be seeing some angels very, very soon. Idyllic Tutor for the Gisela, going for Irois. Very nice. And gonna send the Soul's Attendant into the Calamity. They will go down to 39. Mana Crypt flip on the Aurelia. Hey, that's an Achroma Angel of Wrath coming into play. No mana left over for the Extort, and that will trigger the Soul's Attendant. So looks like Aurelia may also be on the Angel Tribal plan. Who's taking six? No attacks. Oh man, they should have attacked. They should have attacked someone. Mana Crypt comes in tapped. And there's a Calamity coming in tapped. Soul's Attendant will gain another life. It's going to bring it back to our turn. Land tax will trigger. Use the ability. Need some red mana pretty badly, so we'll get two red and a white. And we draw an Emeria Shepherd. Ooh, yeah. The thing we have to watch out for is wheel effects. I don't know how long things are going to stay in our hand, so that's something we'll need to be careful of. But let's get this red mana down right here. Oop, Wrath of God, no, we're not going for Wrath of God just yet. We will go for the Aura of Silence, and we will pass like that. Oh, nice. So Gisela trying to cast the Rhyroas, but Aura of Silence coming down and making it more expensive. So they get stuck right there. Ooh, and they just tap out and pass. Yeah. Aura of Silence, so good. Mana Crypt flip on the Aurelia. Do need to be careful. They can cast Aurelia this turn, and that's going to be a lot of damage in the air. We'll see where they point it. One card that I've been looking at that I actually want to add to this deck that I forgot to do before this game is Walking Atlas. So if you get Walking Atlas down and you're land taxing like this, it's going to become a lot easier to get all those lands from your hand into play. So Aurelia coming into play for the Aurelia opponent seems pretty good. Hopefully they split the damage up and just don't focus us or really anyone else. It's still very, very early in the game, so you know. I don't think anyone's really looking to make a swift exit right here. Coalition Relic coming down for the Aurelia opponent. And that's going to leave one left over for the Blind Obedience. Solemn Simulacrum going to swing into the Gisela. Aurelia into the Calamity. And where's this Achroma going? Aurelia will trigger on attack. And Achroma into us. Okay, opponent's splitting the damage up a little bit. Chroma's still going to hurt. That's still six. And this time, Solemn Simulacrum into us. Achroma into the Gisela. And Aurelia into the Calamity. So we go down to 31 after that exchange. Opponent's going to put a counter on the Coalition Relic. Sure. Mana Crypt and Ivory Giant going to trigger on the upkeep for the Calamity opponent. Opponent going to play a Protector of the Crown. Actually a really cool card. Yeah, there's a couple really cool giants that have some really cool protection abilities on them. Protector of the Crown being one of them. So opponent will get the Monarch token, and that'll actually be good. Should take a little bit of focus off of us. Opponent will want to swing in there at least once. Calamity's choices right here aren't amazing. The Aurelia opponent is ahead, so they'd have to swing into us or the Gisela opponent. I'm not sure that's what they want to do, but that's what they will do. So swinging into the Gisela and Soul's Attendant. Opponent can block with the Soul's Attendant if they want to. 4-4 Calamity. Yeah, I'd probably block too, honestly, especially since, I mean, we're going to lay down this board wipe right here. I feel like Chaotix has probably played enough games with me to know that, like, I'm probably sitting on a board wipe. So end step Monarch token is going to trigger. Opponent gets to draw a card. Very nice. And we're going to let it come back to our turn. Land tax is going to trigger. Let's get a couple more lands. I'm actually just going to get one right here. Since I am looking to wheel at some point, I don't want to dump all of our basics. There are only so many in the deck. We're going to play this mountain. We're going to get down the Boros Signet. Boros Signet comes in tapped. Then we're going to play the Wrath of God. Get rid of these pesky creatures. Oh, the creature's getting blown up. Solemn Simulacrum will die, and opponent will get to draw a card. Yeah, we'll pass a turn like that, and next turn I'm thinking about going Emeria Shepherd, use the Aura of Silence, play a land, and get the Aura of Silence back. Seems like a pretty good place to be. Opponent's going to activate the Shivan Gorge. One damage. Probably not terrible late in the game if you have Gisela out. If you have like two or three damage doublers down, that one damage, it's going to be a lot more than one. Opponent asking if we'll blow up the Blind Obedience. I certainly will, because that card does cause lots and lots of problems for Aurelia. So, yeah. Here comes a Gisela Blade of Gold Knight, so opponent definitely on Angel Tribal. Opponent going to play an Archangel of Thune. Tap their lands in a way to try and use this Shrine of Nykthos. So I'm actually going to sacrifice the Aura of Silence right here. Blow up the Blind Obedience just to take away a little bit of devotion. And upkeep for the Calamity opponent. It's going to be an Ivory Giant and a Mana Crypt trigger. Calamity coming back to play. We can actually Ugin this turn. That seems like a pretty good idea. So I'm going to land tax one more time. Let's get a Plains and a Mountain. Drawn to a Battlefield Forge. Gonna play the Battlefield Forge just in case. Gonna play the Ugin. Someone said, my other pets arrived. Gisella wants the Ugin because they don't have anything in play other than lands, so they are not liable to lose very much. Looks like the biggest thing we need to get rid of is this Archangel of Thune at 5, so we'll go X5. And all the colored permanents, 5 or less, getting exiled. Gets rid of a bunch of creatures on board. Someone said that card needs to be banned. I don't know, like, is Ugin good? Yes, Ugin is really good. But at the end of the day, Ugin is basically just a really, really good board wipe that you then need to kill, like, afterwards. So, I don't know. It's basically just a lot of removal. Like, if I wasn't running Ugin, I'd still be running Allah's Dust. Ugin's a little bit better because it hurts graveyard decks really badly. But, you know, other than that, it's not terribly different from Allah's Dust. Charmbreaker Devil's coming in for the Gisella. Interesting. So, they're probably on some sort of burn plan. Probably going to start laying down lightning bolts and things like that once Gisella comes into play. Mana Crypt Flip for the Aurelia opponent. Pretty sure opponent can recast Aurelia, though. Ugin will definitely take a bullet right there. No way that opponent's gonna leave an Ugin with a hasty creature available. That's a Ray of Dawnbringer for the Aurelia opponent. They have Achroma and Solemn Simulacrum in their graveyard. Both of those are very good. Solemn Simulacrum if you want the lands, and Achroma if you just want another big creature to come in and start hitting things real hard. Which, may actually be a thing. So, if opponent has Raya and Achroma ready to attack and recasts Aurelia, that's a lot of damage. Wouldn't mind seeing a path off the top. Ivory Giant's going to come in and tap all non-white creatures. So, opponent's got a hasty 3-4. We'll likely take down the Ugin. Yep, a swinging into the Ugin. Sure. That does mean that if we landfall the Emeria Shepherd, we could get Ugin back. But Ugin still doesn't solve our Ray of Dawnbringer, Achroma, Aurelia problem. Hedron Archive coming down for the Calumny. And a Burnished Heart. So, opponent getting their ramp on. Going to crack the Burnished Heart. Sure. And opponent gets to draw a card at the end step. We could use a big draw right here. Smothering Tithe is a pretty big draw. Don't really want to give up this Emeria Shepherd, but it's probably the right thing to do. I think we have exactly enough. So there's Smothering Tithe. We're gonna play a Plains, play Reforge the Soul. Get down to the Smothering Tithe business. Opponent's gonna let off a Path to Exile. What are they targeting with it? Oh, they target their own Charmbreaker Devils, trying to get some ramp going. Fair enough. This will give them Gisella mana, so that is, that's really relevant. So if they go Gisella and the Aurelia opponent goes Raya, Achroma, Aurelia, that's potentially deadly to us other two players. Wouldn't mind catching a Swords or a Path right here as we get disconnected. All right, so we are back from the disconnect, and Smothering Tithe triggers a million times. Let's see what we find. We find a Marshall's Anthem, which is really cool. That can get back the Emeria Shepherd. Platinum Angel is reasonable, but it will be prone to removal. Stoneforge Mystic is certainly interesting. Expedition Map and Iona. Iona does cool stuff, right? Iona on white? All right, so I think step one is Iona on white. Sorry, opponents. Next up, I think, is going to be cast Aurelia. Going to play the Expedition Map. Do some attacking. Can't swing into the Raya, sadly. Can't swing into the Gisella. We'll send one their way and one at the Calumny. I did pass on accident. I didn't really mean to pass entirely right there. Oh, we get the Monarch token from the Calumny opponent. Very helpful. So end of combat. Gonna lay down the Platinum Angel just in case things go terribly wrong. Opponents will at least need removal to kill us. And I think we'll leave everything else like that. Would like to leave a few tokens hanging around just so we can have some additional mana for next turn. We get to draw a card with the Smothering Tithe. It is a mountain. Not the most helpful. Smothering Tithe will trigger on our opponent's draw step, and looks like I think they're gonna pay for it. Interesting. Well, alright, yeah. They can't cast white spells. That would do it. So opponent decides to go for a Sublime Archangel, interestingly, with their Raya. Personally, I would have gone for a Chroma first, then the Archangel, but I think I see what they're trying to set up. So if they get a Chroma and a Chroma gets exalted, what, 3 times? That's going to be a 9-9 first strike. We have Platinum Angel, but Platinum Angel could die to red-based artifact removal, is a thing that could happen. Each of our opponents should have a Blasphemous Act. It's a matter of whether they can find it or not. I would assume that if any of them have it, we'll see it by the end of this turn cycle. I don't imagine that they'll let Iona stick around for too long, but opponent's going to crack fetch, and another opponent's going to put a counter on Coalition Relic. Sure. We did get some stuff out of the giant opponent's hand. They had Wrath of God, Return to Dust, Giant Harbinger, Luxodon Warhammer, Warstorm Surge. Yeah, definitely some big hits right there. Oh, the Path of Exile was from the Aurelia opponent. I thought Gisela might have pathed themselves for the mana. I mean, sometimes you gotta path yourself. Sometimes you really need that land. Gilded Lotus coming down for the Calemni opponent. And the Gisela opponent discarded an Avacyn and Irois Gauntlet of Power. So yeah, Reforge the Soul. So, so good. Opponent's gonna crack their Hedron Archive for two cards. Sure. Looking for that answer. That will trigger the Smothering Tithe. Here's an Inferno Titan. That's a start. That can definitely do some things. Yep, opponent gonna shoot us in the face with it. Totally warranted. Totally understand. That's gonna bring it back to our turn. We draw a mountain. Let's play the Plains. Get the Stoneforge Mystic. Let's find out if Sunforger's in this deck. I kind of go back and forth between including it and not including it. Though Mask of Memory would not be the worst option either. Would not mind drawing some more stuff. No Sunforger currently, so we'll go for the Mask of Memory. Play the Mask of Memory. Go to combat. Gonna go after the Calemni opponent. They do not appear to have any flying. Uh-oh. Nope, opponent's gonna Shivan Gorge. Okay. So we get into the Calemni opponent, and Mask will trigger. We draw Tithe and Plains, not the most helpful. Let us get rid of a mountain right here. Iona into the Calemni, Aurelia into the Gisela. Platinum Angel is gonna stay back, and hopefully we don't die to something random. So Calemni down, Mask of Memory will trigger. We draw Thran Dynamo, Boros Garrison, discard the Tithe, and we will pass like that. We get to draw off of the Monarch token. There's a Herald of War. Crux Thumb coming down for the Gisela. Interesting. Opponent gonna continue to Shivan Gorge. Sure. And opponent's gonna use the Arcane Lighthouse. Let's see what they got. No one really has Hexproof or Shroud, though. So Rhea, Mana Crypt, Mana Vault will trigger for the Aurelia opponent. Achroma coming in for the Aurelia opponent. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Smothering Tithe will trigger for us. Aurelia is going to pass no attacks and leaves all their mana up. Probably stuck on a bunch of white cards would be the assumption. Just go to combat right here. Swing into the Gisela opponent. Aurelia will trigger. Gisela down to 7. Mask of Memory will trigger. We draw two Adarkar Valkyrie. Gonna discard a mountain right here. Attack like that. So Gisela out of the game. Mask of Memory will trigger again. We draw two High Market and a Boros Charm. Discard the Windswept Heath. Play the High Market just in case. And let's get down some of these other angels. So get our three angels into play. Pass the turn like that. Opponent's gonna need something big. Ugin would be a very good start. We draw a Return to Dust off of the Monarch token. Rhea's gonna trigger. Gets a Solemn Simulacrum. Not bad. So Solemn Simulacrum comes in. Opponent gets a card. Smothering Tithe will trigger for us. Opponent's gonna pay. So that brings it back to our turn. And I think we just go in through the front door right here. Boros Charm if we need to. Attack with everything. Aurelia trigger on the stack. We're gonna target Iona. Herald of War will get a counter on it. Oh, we could have Boros Charm, Blasphemous Act. That would have cleared out all the blockers. Whoops. So we'll play the Boros Charm. So Rhea goes down. Mask of Memory will trigger. Archangel of Thune will trigger. And opponent's going to scoop it right there. Fair enough. Good game to our opponents. I may have committed a party foul by naming white with Iona. Iona on white against three Boros decks. Pretty good. I told opponents I would rematch them and not play Iona. So, yeah, we'll wait for the rematch and see how that goes. So, yeah, this is exactly how this deck has been playing out lately. Just doing nasty, nasty things, usually at the hands of Smothering Tithe, but Iona also being a powerhouse and shutting down lots and lots of things. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, feel free to comment, like, or subscribe. Thank you for watching.